Okay, let's scroll up a little more to look at the second half of the problem. Now that we've got all the preliminaries out of the way, how do we actually launch a kernel on the GPU? So here's a new piece of syntax in CUDA, the CUDA launch operator. So the CUDA launch operator is indicated by these three less than signs and these three greater than signs with some parameters in the middle. So this line says, launch the kernel name square on one block of 64 elements. Then the arguments to the kernel are two pointers, d underscore out and d underscore in. This code tells the CPU to launch on the GPU 64 copies of the kernel on 64 threads. Note that we can only call the kernel on GPU data, not CPU data. Since we named our GPU data to start with d underscore, we can visually see that we've done the right thing. Then when we're done with the kernel, the results are in d underscore out on the GPU, and this CUDA memcopy call will move memory from device to host and place it in h underscore out. The next thing we do is print it out. Okay, we're just walking through the h underscore out array. We're printing four things per line, so we're putting tabs in and then a new line after four. And then we free the memory that we allocated on the GPU and return zero. So that's all the CPU code. There's a fair amount of boilerplate in here. It looks fairly similar for most programs. Most programs are going to have you create some data on the CPU, allocate some data on the GPU, copy memory from CPU to GPU, launch some kernels that will run on the GPU, copy the results back to the CPU, and then continue to process them, print them, and so on.